So good morning. I want to thank all you guys for coming today to remember our mom. It is a true testament of how much she was loved and cared for by all of you being here today. Our family would like to thank everyone for their kindness during this difficult time. It is amazing how good and kind people are. Also, we would like to thank Mark Thurston for providing us this place to conduct the graveside services. It keeps us out of the heat at the cemetery, so that was really kind of him to allow us to do it here. He's taken good care of Mom, and we really appreciate what he's done for us. So we're going to start the service with an opening prayer given by Shandy Lishman, our granddaughter. And then we will hear the song Silver Wings, sung by Lane Dancy, the grandson. Mom requested Lane to sing this song for her. So after that, we will continue the service just as outlined on the program. So
dear Father in heaven, we humbly bow our heads this day with gratitude in our hearts for our many blessings. We are thankful for the safe travel of those who gathered here today for the common bond that has brought us together. We come before you today to honor the life of Louis. We ask that you will be with us as we remember her life and her legacy. We thank you for all the years you gave her to us. She was and still is so loved. We know that her spirit continues to live on. Please bless those who knew and loved her, especially those who are closest to her and are grieving, and give them peace and comfort as they continue their journey without her. And please give extra comfort to those who still need guidance. Please watch over her children as they face the heartbreaking task of living without her. Let them know how much she loved them and how proud she is of them. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Silver wings shining in the sunlight, roaring engines headed somewhere in flight. They're taking you away and leaving me lonely. Silver wings slowly fading out of sight. Don't leave me, I cry. Don't take that airplane ride. But you locked me out of your mind and left me standing here behind. Silver wings shining in the sunlight, roaring engines in flight. Lonely. Silver wings shining in the sunlight. Roaring engines headed somewhere in flight. They're taking you away and leaving me lonely. Silver wings slowly fading out of sight. Slowly fading out of sight.
Let's see if we can get this accomplished today. Luann Hale Shrives, September 1st, 1941, July 13th, 2022, Logan. Luann Louie Shrives left us July 13th from complications of kidney failure. Luann was born September 1st, 1941, in Afton, Wyoming, to John and Wyoma Hale. The family later moved to Hyde Park, where she grew up, went to school, and graduated from North Cache High School. Louie married Farrell Lishman and was the proud mom of four children. They were later divorced, and she was married to Ronald Shrives until his passing in 1999. Louie worked at Smith's for 36 years, first in the meat department, then she became a cashier for the remainder of her time there. She loved her job and all the friends she made during that time. Even if some other cashier lines were empty, people would wait in her line just so they could talk to her. Louie loved to bowl and enjoyed being with her girlfriends on their Wednesday night league. She also played in several tournaments, traveling to different states with her team. Louie loved people, and everywhere she went, she knew someone she had to talk with. If you went anywhere with her, you had to allow extra time for her to socialize. Louie loved her family more than anything, and was always excited to see them. She loved music, horse rides, dancing, and life in general. Louie is survived by her four children and their spouses, Kevin and Lana Lishman of Clinton, Utah, Tina and Lynn, deceased, Greer of Bothell, Utah, Pamela and John Burley of Nibley, Utah, Corey John and Casey Lishman of Trenton, Utah. Stepchildren, Cindy Bolin, Rhonda and Kent Dancy, Linda Sohn, and Jerry Griffith Hampton. She is also survived by 15 grandchildren and 30 great-grandchildren. Louie had four brothers and one sister. She was preceded in death by her parents, older brother John, younger brother Tom, and two great-grandsons. She is survived by her sister, Liz Leon Payne, and her brothers, Dan Jill Hale and David Malia Hale. The family would like to extend their gratitude to the nursing staff and doctors at Logan Regional Hospital for the amazing care they provided.
It truly is an honor
to be here today to honor the life of Lou Anne Shrives. I'm pretty sure she had something to do with this. Whether she gets the last joke on me or possibly I get the last joke on her, because if I get all choked up, it'll be short and sweet, just like she likes it. Only Louie could be in the hospital, joking, giggling one day and slipped off and gone the next. Now that's true fashion to me. Can you imagine the reunion and the party? That's been going on with Grandpa Ron, her parents, and other siblings that have passed on. I can just imagine the party. This is one rich lady. And I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about family. How proud she was and is of her children, the grandchildren. The stories that she's told. I don't know if bragging is the right word, but you know, she was really proud of her family. That's what was important to her, you know. Stories from, you know, building and remodeling houses, trading horses. How dang cute her kids were. She was proud of the kids in her family who served missions. And how good her kids have taken care of her. And the bottom line, I know where the kids learned, where they learned service from, because she was of service to everyone. I think back years ago when Grandpa Ron got so sick and spent 3+ years or 3+ months in the LDS hospital, when they didn't give him a 0.5% of a chance ever coming home, how she never left his side. I don't know that she went home during that time. And when he did come home, proved them all wrong. Then the service that she gave him and how she took care of him. I don't know anybody that could have done a better job or been more loving. The story about her working in Smith's and people standing in her line, I can see that happen. I could see myself standing in her line just to rattle her chain just a tiny bit. Some of the last times that we talked, I mean, she'd call me on the phone. I'd be on my truck and, you know, we'd visit for an hour or two at a time sometimes. And at different times at her home, you know, the last few times, I mean, she talked about going home. She wasn't scared. You know, she was ready. She'd ran her race in this life and done the things that she was proud of and raised an awesome family. And I know for a fact
She knew the Savior's voice. And he called her home by name, Sister Luann. I'm not one to do much preaching, but we'll all feel her spirit from time to time when she's trying to direct us in the right directions. That's just because of the love she has for each one of us. I testify of the plan of happiness that the Savior's laid out for us, you know, that we did live prior to this life. We probably knew each other. Many of us knew each other. And we're going to live again, just like she is right now. I'm pretty positive I must have known her in the pre-existence, because our hearts touched somehow special. That's why she was so easy to love. Each one of us, especially her family members, you know, has an awesome example to follow. You know, just like she did. She loved everyone. She took care of each other and learned for us to learn how to take care of each other. And probably the most important thing is mend any fences that need mended. Our relationships here in this life are probably the most important things that we can take care of. I bury my testimony that Sister Luann is happy and doing well, and it won't be long till each one of us is going to get to pass through that deal she's going through right now, or has gone through. I appreciate her family sharing her with us. I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Ten notes came with me or less, that I had to say goodbye so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you just walk right through that. And tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God's word. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. always made my troubles feel so small. You were always there to catch me if I fall. In a world heroes come and go, where God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Love is on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows what. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah.
Grandma, can you hear me? Grandma, the moment that you died, my heart was torn in two. One side filled with heartache, the other died with you. I often lay awake at night when the world is fast asleep and take a walk down memory lane with tears upon my cheeks. Remembering you is easy. I do it every day. But missing you is heartache that never goes away. I hold you tightly within my heart, and there you will remain until the joyous day arrives that we will meet again.
So a little bit of change in the program. I've asked Mom's younger brother, David, to get up and just say a few things about their childhood, which, you know, a lot of us didn't know about being her kid. But so, hey, Mo.
What's the old saying? Here goes nothing. Childhood with Lou. It wasn't just Lou, it was the whole family. We had some rough times, but every one of them rough times was so much fun. I was gonna say Lou was the only strength in my family, but they all were. John, the oldest brother, he was, you hear people a little rough on the red around the edges. I mean, John plain had thorns. But a heart that was bigger than this room. Liz was just crazy Lizzie all her life, but full of love. Tom, we had some problems, separated from our family for lots of years. But we got to know him at the end when Mom died and come back into the flock, I guess you could say. We got to know him a little. Dan, just been by my side, just like the rest of them. But Lou had this spark of love for kids that I've never seen. Put a kid in front of her, that was all it took. At the hospital, I know all the ones who were there, we witnessed God and work. One minute she has a tube down her throat, all but dead. The next minute she's sitting up in bed chatting with all of us. If that ain't God's hand, I don't know what is. Walked in and talked to her just like nothing was wrong with the lady. She smiled, she laughed, she talked about the old times. I still threatened her that she better not die before me because I didn't want to stand in her line. She had her sense of humor up, smiled. I mean, the love that was in that hospital is unexplainable. Through all of you guys, through our Heavenly Father, through everything. True testimony to me that God does live, and that should be a testimony to all of us that were witnessed what we witnessed. She was a great sister, a great person, and she'll be very welcome up the stairs, I'll tell you. She's going to where we all are trying to get. And I think everybody in this room is going to get there. Just my thinking. If I make it, you're safe. I got a little, last night, Kevin threw this on me, the good friend that he is. And now if I can find it. And I can read it and get through it. I think this kind of sums her all up, in my opinion. You can shed tears because they are gone, or you can smile because they lived. You can close your eyes and pray they will come back, or you can open your eyes and see all that they left for you. Your heart can be empty because you can't see them, or you can be full of the love you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember only that they are gone, or you can cherish their memory and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind and feel empty, or you can do what they would want, smile, open your heart, love, and go on. And I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
So how do you squeeze nearly 81 years of life into a few short minutes? Pretty hard to do. Mom was a feisty lady. As a single mom, she had the determination to move us from Hyde Park, where she built us a new house and raised her family there in Logan. For a single mom, that was a lot. She had a lot on her plate, but she managed to get through it. She always made sure we had what we needed. There was very seldom that we didn't get what we needed. What we wanted was a different thing, but what we needed, we always had it. She never complained much about anything. Even when you knew she was not feeling the best, she would say, "I'm feeling pretty good today." She was one of a kind for sure. So I just put together a list of a few of Mom's favorite things. Her favorite color, like purple. Yeah, she loved purple. Her favorite time of the day. Oh, wait a minute, I'm missing something here. Okay. Sorry. Her favorite food, not pasta. So a little background with that. She had Meals on Wheels come in the last couple of years. She commented that they served a lot of pasta. She was quite the food critic. She would make notes on the Meals on Wheels calendar that showed, you know, what was being served for that day. One comment I seen was chicken not done. Another one was just yuck. So, yeah. And she let them know when they brought it, the delivery person to come the next day, and she let them know that it wasn't quite up to her standards. So, yeah. Her favorite drink, Diet Cherry Vanilla Dr. Pepper. Her favorite time of day, 3 o'clock to watch her favorite show, Judge Judy. Her favorite sports team, Utah Jazz. Her favorite sports to play was softball. She's quite the softball player back in her younger day. I remember going down and watching her play, and she could run those bases faster than I can imagine. Just a little short, stocky lady, and she could run them bases like you could not believe. She was a fast little cuss. Her favorite place was home. Her favorite pet, Cosmo, her little Shih Tzu. Y'all remember little Cosmo, right? Her favorite phrase, like I said. Second favorite phrase, I'm still here. I guess I haven't pissed enough people off. Yeah, these are just a few of many things about Mom. I'm sure many of you have memories of her that will keep her in your hearts. Mom loved her family more than anything. You always felt welcome in her home. She loved to visit and enjoyed the company. She loved the outings she would go on with people that come by and pick her up, take her for a drive. She just wanted to go see what had changed out there since the last time she was out. She had her driver's license taken away a couple years ago, and that about killed her. It was taken away her total independence. So she was happy to see somebody show up and take her on an outing. So just a few things about Mom. I'm sure all of you have plenty more. that you can think about. But anyway, just got to let you know that I get the privilege of driving the hearse to the cemetery. I know, right? Yeah, and my little brother, Corey John, is riding shotgun. Yeah, so I'm sure she's probably stoked, but I know I am. And it'll kind of be our last time driving Miss Daisy, right? So one more thing I got to tell you. During one of her ambulance rides down, she was transported down to McKay-D, and one of her, I believe it's when she had a heart attack quite a while ago. She let the paramedics know it was the bumpiest ride she had ever had. She told them, "I think you missed one of them bumps. You may want to go back and hit it." Yeah. I'm just hoping Corey and I don't hear that on the way to the cemetery. Yeah. If we do, we'll know we got to piss her off just one more time. Anyway, Mom had a good life. She was a good mom and loved by a lot of people. She will truly be missed. We love you, Mom.
Oh, Our beloved Heavenly Father, we are so grateful to be gathered here as family and friends. To remember the life of our wonderful Grandma Lou, and to feel thy sweet spirit that has come over us to bring us peace and joy and happiness in this moment. Father, we ask thee for strength, for guidance, and feel thy spirit as we look back on the days we spent with her. That we may feel thy love and thy joy in every one of those moments. Father, we're grateful for the speakers and for the messages shared and for the wonderful services provided. Father, we ask thee for safety as we travel out to Franklin Cemetery and that thy spirit reside with us in the coming days. As we mourn and remember her, Father, we're grateful for thy plan and for the knowledge that we will be able to see her once again as we return home with thee. And we ask thee to please embrace her and embrace all of us. And all these things we say humbly in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.